Next, I'll explain the three types of counterexamples you'll see on tests. The first case is the formation of a precipitate. Through this reaction here, hydrosulfuric acid, a very weak acid, can produce a strong acid. This reaction can occur because the resulting copper sulfide has an extremely small solubility product constant. Textbooks give a value on the order of 10 to the negative 36 power. This means that in the solution, as long as the concentration of copper ions multiplied by the concentration of sulfide ions is greater than 10 to the negative 36th, they will react to form a copper sulfide precipitate. We know that hydrosulfuric acid is a diprotic weak acid, and it undergoes a two-step ionization in solution. Through these two steps, the resulting sulfide ion concentration is about 10 to the negative 15th moles per liter. Now, for a copper sulfate solution, let's take the common concentration of 0.1 moles per liter as an example. The product of the copper ion and sulfide ion concentrations is 10 to the negative 16th, which is much, much greater than 10 to the negative 36th. Even as the reaction proceeds, and the copper ion concentration drops from 0.1 to, say, 10 to the negative 5th moles per liter, and the sulfide ion concentration drops from 10 to the negative 15th to 10 to the negative 20th moles per liter. At that point, the product of the sulfide and copper ion concentrations is 10 to the negative 25th, which is still much, much greater than 10 to the negative 36th. In chemistry, when an ion's concentration drops below 10 to the negative 5th moles per liter, we consider that ion to be completely precipitated. So when you bubble hydrogen sulfide gas through a copper sulfate solution, you can completely precipitate the copper ions. This means the reaction proceeds to a very large extent, so we use an equal sign to connect them. Now, if I replace copper sulfate with mercury sulfate or silver sulfate, the reaction will still occur. That's because the KSP values for mercury sulfide and silver sulfide are also extremely small. From this, we can see that these three sulfides are insoluble in sulfuric acid. You must pay close attention to this point. Aside from the sulfides of copper, mercury, and silver, which are insoluble in acids like sulfuric and hydrochloric acid, most other common metal sulfides are soluble in them. For example, if I were to replace copper sulfate with ferrous sulfate or manganese sulfate, the reaction would be very unlikely to happen. This is because the solubility product of ferrous sulfide is about 10 to the negative 18th, while the KSP for manganese sulfide is about 10 to the negative 14th. Again, using our common example of 0.1 moles per liter, both the ferrous and manganese ions are at 0.1. The sulfide ion concentration is 10 to the negative 15th. Their product is 10 to the negative 16th, which is less than 10 to the negative 14th. So if we switch to manganese sulfate, the reaction basically won't happen at all. Now, if we switch to ferrous sulfate, 10 to the negative 16th is greater than 10 to the negative 18th. So initially the reaction can occur. But as the reaction proceeds, the concentrations of both the ferrous ions and the sulfide ions will decrease. Very quickly, their product will become less than 10 to the negative 18th. The reaction doesn't proceed to a great extent. If the forward reaction doesn't proceed much, the reverse reaction will proceed to a great extent. Therefore, ferrous sulfide and manganese sulfide can be dissolved by sulfuric acid. But as we said earlier, copper sulfide, mercury sulfide, and silver sulfide